Hi, welcome to Bradley Bro Gaming channel. Today I'm gonna show a tutorial, super easy 2PC streaming setup for a laptop using OBS NDI without using a capture card. So without further ado, come with me. All right, once again, thank you so much for stopping by to watch this video. Just a reminder, if you're new on the channel, don't forget to subscribe or just like in the video, help the channel grow. And let's talk about how to do the streaming with the two PCs. I usually do with two laptops. You can do with the desktop as well. If you do have a second PC or if you do have a second laptop laying around, you can actually divide the load of your PC for streaming to the second PC. So you can have one PC for, let's say, if you wanna play or your games, or if you want to do other things on there, you can also load your second laptop for a just encoder, just for streaming to the platform that you wish, either YouTube, either Twitch. So I'm going to start to, you're going to need three things. You're going to need to download OBS Studio, and that's what I use it. I use some Streamlabs, which I like it, but I personally prefer OBS Studio because you have so many plugins on that you can use for your stream. And I really like the way to how it works. But this tutorial will be just for OBS Studio. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna actually download OBS Studio in both laptops. A reminder for you guys that you can also use two desktop PCs. Just let you guys know a laptop because that's what I use and it's been working for me. So you can go ahead, download OBS Studio, the latest version, to your gaming PC and to your streaming PC. The other thing that you need to use and that you're gonna need to download is OBS NDI plugin. You gotta go to this website to download OBS NDI, the latest version. And if you download OBS Studio 25.0, I think it's 0.0.8 by the time you're watching this video, just download the latest one as a show. And you're gonna download on your gaming PC and you're gonna download on your streaming PC. Also, after you download, make sure that you install in your both machines. Make sure that OBS Studio is not on, and make sure that it's not open. Just make sure you close OBS Studio, restart your machines, and open again. And I'm gonna show you a tutorial right now in both computers, one in a game PC and another in a laptop streaming PC. Just come with me. Okay, so this is the gaming PC. And I have already installed OBS Studio 25.0.8. This is the latest one until this, you'll be watching this video. So it could be the 26 already, but just download the latest one. So when you download and you put this in your PC, that's things that you need to do. First of all, if you already have your scenes on your game PC right here, that's fine, you can keep it. I usually leave right here on this laptop right here, the gaming PC. The only thing I do for my streaming PC is basically the encoding, that's it. So all my things I'll be here. Right now that's nothing, but I wanted to show you how we start. So first thing you need to do after you download also OBS is the plugin NDI. Let's go to the settings first. In here you just connect your Twitch account or YouTube account, whatever account that you need to use this for. I leave this just like that because I'm not going to be streaming from this laptop, the gaming laptop. I'm going to be streaming through the streaming laptop. So we just leave this as it is. Over here, it's just the way it's I don't know how you use it. I do leave everything disabled, and I actually add all my sources one by one individual. So I'm not gonna go through this. I just wanna go through exactly what you need to be doing, which is this part right here, which is the important part. The resolution. My resolution, my screen is 1920 by 1080. What I do when I stream, I stream at 720. So what I do, this is the very important part. If you want to stream at 720, you do just like this. You, this is the setup that I do. I use the Lanczos sharpening scaling 36 samples and 60 FPS. If you want to stream at 1080, then you have to change here 1080. Then you leave at 1080. Because this is the output is what you're going to send to your streaming PC. But since I do 720, that's how I leave like that. Remember, in your streaming PC, you have to make sure that this and this right here are matching. And the output has to match the base over there. Okay, I'm gonna show as well there. Nothing over here and nothing over here, but this is for the gaming PC. Now, one thing, after you install the NDI OBS plugin, you're gonna come here within tools and you're gonna see that's a NDI output settings. If you install correctly, you're gonna see that option right here. Once you click it, you're gonna see I already have my name, my gaming PC name already here. What you're gonna do, you're gonna have this option. You're gonna put the name of your gaming PC right here so it can recognize on a streaming PC. You're gonna click main output right there, and what's going to do is gonna allow to send everything, audio, video, and through NDI through your streaming PC. So just make sure that you put a name over here, because on the stream PC, I will show in a moment that you have to match, and it actually you have to look for this name that you put in right here. Okay, so this is just for the gaming PC setup, and I'm now gonna show you the streaming PC or the laptop. All right, so now we are here on the stream PC laptop. And as you see right here, I have the OBS Studio 25.0.8, the latest one. And they also, I download the OBS NDI as well on this machine, like we did in both machines. So after that, after download and everything's fine, and what you're gonna do, you're gonna go to the settings. So we start with the settings on my stream PC. I go to make sure here you have your Twitch, YouTube, your Facebook account, the account you want to stream. Output, what I do here, you can put actually 5,000 or fans. I usually put 6,000 over here. It doesn't go more than that anyway, but just put 6,000 on video bitrate. Encoder I'm using because my laptop stream PC does not have any GPU like NVIDIA or something related, so I'm doing the CPU. So I'm using X264 and I'm using 320 audio bitrate right here. I don't touch nothing else over here. I use a same as stream for recording. And over here, the only thing I change is MP4. I prefer to use MP4. That's it for this part. The audio, I leave everything the way it is. The only thing I change is the sample rate for 48 kilohertz right here. Leave it in stereo. Going to video, this is the part that's more important. You gotta match what you have there, an output of your gaming PC. My output on gaming PC is 720. So you gotta put your output here from your gaming PC and what you want to stream. It's definitely like I say, I'll be streaming on 720, so I usually output there 720, and over here I just capture 720 and stream 720. So just make sure that this right here matches your output on your gaming PC, and over here is what you're gonna stream, what you want to stream for. Now this is also gonna match. Over there was 36 samples using this one right here I was using there, and 60. So this is gotta be matched right here. Match those two to from your gaming PC, match your output from your gaming PC, and this is what you're gonna actually stream for. And this is pretty much it for the settings. I don't touch anything else. You just click apply, click OK. Now you're gonna have to restart. All right, so the OBS Studio restarted. So I'm just gonna, that's gonna check here, because after the restart, just make sure that all everything we put it is still here. The 6000, there we go, everything matches everything. Because you gotta restart, they ask for restart to make sure that everything's syncing right here. Cool. All right, so after that, the only thing you gotta do, if you install the OBS and EDI, plug it in correctly, you're gonna go here on your sources and you're gonna edit a source, and you're gonna see that it's an EDI source right here. If you see that everything was correctly installed on the streaming PC, so just click on EDI source and you're gonna see this window right here. Click OK and see right here, source name. In your gaming PC, you're gonna see the name that you choose, and an EDI source right there. Whatever the name you put it in, you're probably gonna see over here. Eventually, you're gonna see over here, you click it, because that's the source you're gonna capture the sound and a video from there. And this right here is bandwidth. Since you're connecting, for this working in a really good and effective way, you have to actually connect your laptop to your with the Ethernet cable to a switch, and the switch to your router, and your laptop for your streaming the same way to your switch, the internet switch, into your router. Make sure that switch is 1 gigabyte for internet speed, so that way make you will make the sync way better and better quality. The bandwidth is the highest, I put it right here as well, and the sync will be through the network with the Ethernet cable. I leave everything else the way it is. I click OK, and you should see in a moment, there we go. This is my gaming PC right there. And I'm just gonna go over here and make sure that it stretches the screen. So that's why you're seeing right here is a little bit choppy right now. If you can see, it's just because I'm using to record this video, the Streamlabs. So, but it is very good, and that's it. And that's exactly what you need to do. And after you've done that, you're ready to go. Okay, so one thing that I forgot to mention over here is when you go and have your NEDI output set, this already check it to actually send to your streaming PC. And let's say you want to go to the settings and you want to go to the video and you want to change right here. You're not going to be able to do it because your output is on over there. So for you to do that, you got to go to Tools, NEDI, and uncheck this box, click OK, go to settings, then you can actually change whatever you need here or for your stream PC. If you want to change here or here, that's how you change. So you had to go over there and the Tools, NEDI, make sure this is unchecked. When you do any changes that you need to do, just go ahead and check again, click OK, and set to go to stream on your send to your streaming PC. All right, so yeah, so this is it. So once you do all that, you're good to go, be able to use a second PC or a second laptop for your streaming. Don't forget to don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget, if you like this video, to give you a like on there as well. Put in the comments if you would like to see anything again, as some videos like this on some topics. Just put in the comments down there. Thank you so much for coming by, stop by and watch this video. Rotterdam Gamer